Mr. Marshall, would you please introduce for the audience the main products you bring to the show and what are the technical features and benefits to the customers in China?
Since 1903, Pallmann is a very strong family company. In the last century, we have developed many different machine kinds for our customers. We have today more than 1,000 machine types for the plastic industry, for the wood industry, for food and chemicals. We are looking back to more than 45,000 tests we have done and test reports, which helps us to define with the customer his best solution to improve his market and improve his competitive position on the market. And China is for us a very great market, very big market. Since decades, we have now very good friends and customers in China to whom we have delivered the machine and to whom we are still developing interesting projects today.
Pallmann is apparently very experienced in delivering innovative technologies to our customers. So what are the key success factors?
Our key success factors are our customers. Our philosophy is not to supply machines from a catalog. We want to develop with our customers and for our customers the best and most innovative solution for them.
So what specific needs and growth opportunities do you see in the Chinese market?
China is a huge and very fascinating market. We are on this market since decades now, working with our customers and our friends for developing new solution and the best adapted solution for them. We are not only providing machine for reusing materials, but we are also providing solutions for our customers for entering and creating new market opportunities.
How do you see the Chinese market? Do you have any special development plans here?
We have a long time presence now in China, and the Chinese market is changing fast and is getting more and more competitive. But with our customers, we are recognizing the challenges and the opportunities for tomorrow. And with them, we are developing the solution, the best adapted solution, the most economic and the most technically developed for them, for staying on the market and for creating new opportunities and new markets.
Hello. 我们德国帕尔曼集团呢是世界领先的物料细化处理设备供应商。今天在广州像素展上，我们给广大的中国客户介绍的是带来展示的是三套，用于不同行业的细化处理设备。现在大家看到第一套是塑料的磨粉机，跟我们普通的 磨粉机相比呢，它的主要优势是什么呢？它的体积非常小巧，但是它的产能啊，包括它的能耗啊，都是非常的理想。另外的话，普通的磨粉机一般通常只能处理 PE 这些比较容易的材料，但是我们的磨粉机可以处理比较热敏感度非常高的材料，比如说 PP 啊、PA 啊这类材料。大家通过这个镜头可以看到我们磨粉机的内部，这是我们的核心的心脏。可以看到它的细节在于，磨粉机是由两个大的盘面组成，这面呢是它的动刀面，这面是它的进刀面。那么每个盘面呢上面都有30片相同尺寸大小的 排列规则的刀的一道一道刀轮的，我们叫刀盘组，每一盘有30板。通过这两盘动刀和定刀的旋转，就产生相应的剪切力。物料从上面进入这个研磨机内部以后，它就进行剪切的作用。 它的作用呢，就是跟普通机研磨，虽然我们平常讲磨粉机啊，但是它实际上它真正的反应过程是一个剪切的过程，并不是说磨的过程，因为磨的话产生的热量太大，但是切的话，我们都可以知道用剪刀切，它的热量最小化，这就是为什么，因为它的热量最低，所以可以用 处理一些对热量温度特别敏感的材料，但是我们普通的别家的磨粉机就是做不到的，这是它的主要优势。这套设备呢是橡胶破碎机，我们可以看到它的体积非常小巧，但是它的产能是非常惊人的，一个小时可以处理2吨的一个橡胶量，可以将整块的橡胶，是整块的橡胶，不需要预先的破碎切碎，直接把它投入到它的刀组里面，它的我们讲它的反应舱里面，然后反应舱我们可以看到它的细节啊，跟普通的破碎机有什么不一样呢？它的反应舱是空心的，中空的，它的刀是在它的那个转子轴上面。为什么有这个中空的设计呢？主要是为了让这个物料在破碎的过程中可以在转子的内部进行运动，可以移动。另外的话，它可以有更大的空间，让空气进入，所以让它的热量可以及时的带走。因为大家知道橡胶材料特别的在温度升高以后就容易粘接，所以我们必须非常小心的让它的热量最小化，或者是让它尽快的被带走。这是我们一款荣誉产品了，因为我们在国内已经拥有众多的用户了，包括刚刚介绍的这款磨机也是在国内已经拥有非常多的用户了。今天展台上的第三套设备呢，我们叫废料回收再生造粒设备，它可以回收包括塑料的纤维，或者是泡沫，或者是薄膜，包括其他织物，都可以通过这台设备进行粉碎再生造粒。跟我们平常可能接触到的回收再生造粒不同的地方，主要是它并不是通过融化熔融造粒挤出造粒的，而是通过它自然的一个摩擦产生的热量，在低于它融化点的状态下进行造粒。因为这个设备没有对物料进行融化，所以就不需要采用额外的加热系统，所以它的能耗是最小化的。跟普通的熔融造粒系统相比的，我们这台设备它的能耗只有它们的1/3。